Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to talk about another adapter in SAP CPI, which is Datastore adapter in SAP CPI. Let's begin. What is Datastore adapter? Before I begin, I want to explain what is a Datastore in SAP CPI. In SAP CPI, we have something called Datastore, which is a temporary Datastore in SAP CPI tenant. We can use this data store to read and write the messages from different integration flows. By using this data store, you can make the integration processes asynchronous and more decoupled. For example, you can have integration process A and integration process B. We can use this data store to write the data from integration process A, and in the integration process B, you can read the data from this data store to have a decoupling effect between these two integration processes. Datastore adapter supports both sender-side communication and receiver-side communication, which means you can read the data from the Datastore and write the data to a Datastore. Let's talk about what are the different applications we can use to integrate by using this Datastore adapter. You can use this Datastore adapter when you have a requirement for a temporary storage or delayed processing of the messages between multiple integration processes. We can use this adapter to integrate both SAP and non-SAP applications. Remember, when you want to build loose coupled integrations, when you have a requirement for temporary storage, you need to use Datastore in SAP CPI. Let's now talk about what are the do's and don'ts of using Datastore adapter. Use Datastore adapter for scenarios that require message persistence, buffering, or sequencing. Use this adapter for Datastore operation features to perform various operations on Datastore, such as write, get, select, and delete. By using this adapter, you can use variable features to store and retrieve values from Datastore. Let's now talk about what are the don'ts of using this adapter. Don't use this adapter for scenarios that require complex data transformation or processing, as adapter only supports basic storage and retrieval operations. Don't use data storage adapter for scenarios that require high performance or real-time data exchange, as the adapter may introduce latency and overhead. Don't use the data store adapter for scenarios that require data encryption or compression, as the adapter does not support these features. Let's now talk about what are the configuration parameters that we need to set to configure a Datastore adapter. In a Datastore adapter, you need to specify the Datastore name and the visibility of the Datastore. For example, a visibility can be a global or local. And in the processing section, you need to specify operations type like get, write, select, or delete, and the message ID or the correlation ID. In the advanced section, you need to specify the retry policy, timeout, or proxy settings, or the message size. Let's now talk about what are the main issues of using a Datastore adapter. The Datastore adapter does not support Datastore operations in the test tool, and the adapter does not support Datastore operations in the local integration process. And you need to be careful when using this Datastore adapter in terms of error handling process or parallel processing handling. So that's it about Datastore adapter. If you want to practice real-time scenario around Datastore adapter, please check my scenario 1 where I explained an end-to-end scenario by using Datastore adapter. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, consider giving a like, share the video, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching.